distinguished participants and panelists on the dais, excellencies, honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum, namaskar, sat sri akal, and a very good morning to all of you. First of all, I congratulate the organizers for convening this important forum, and I thank them for inviting me to participate in the inaugural session. Some 37 years ago, or nearly 38 years ago, a very eminent statesman and economist on the world stage had rubbished the emergence of Bangladesh as doomed to be a perpetual basket case. The new nation that emerged defied conventional wisdom and confounded doomsday prophecies. Recently, our finance minister, in a speech, termed Bangladesh as a country of impossible attainments. Ours is a country known widely for floods, hartals, poverty. At least that's what you see popping up on the media screens the world over. But allow me, ladies and gentlemen, also to inform you that this same tiny poverty-stricken country with more than 150 million people has sustained nearly 6% GDP growth rate in recent years, and prior to that maintained 5% or above in the previous 15 years. We have doubled our ready-made garment export in the last 4 years, quintupled foreign remittance in the last decade despite global economic downturn and negative growth by many countries. The country's gender parity in education and reduction of child and maternal mortality have been hailed as exemplary in the world. Recently, the Honorable Mrs. Sonia Gandhi, chairperson of the UPA Alliance in Dhaka, very graciously paid us a tribute and said Bangladesh's human development indices had surpassed those of India. It's a tribute which is humbling to us and at the same time inspiring for us. Our modest achievements are due largely to our policy of focusing on equity as well as growth, and perhaps privileging the former a little more than the latter. To this line of impossible attainments, we have taken up an additional challenge in this century of bringing e-governance to the ordinary man. If democracy is, as conventionally accepted, government of the people, for the people, by the people, democracy becomes meaningless unless the people are empowered. And this we can only do through bringing e-governance and making the honorable, the ordinary person empowered or feeling empowered in having a say on how the government functions and how he receives or how she receives services from the government. This concept that the present elected government, led by Sheikh Hasina, launched after it assumed office in early 2009, is called governance by transforming Bangladesh into digital Bangladesh. The concept has two basic themes. The first theme is taking services to citizens' doorsteps. Digital Bangladesh cannot be considered analogous to growth of information and communications ITC sector of the country alone. Digital Bangladesh is about taking services to where citizens live so they don't have to travel great distances, stand in long queues, or run from one government office to another endlessly. I think in our part of the world, in the subcontinent, we are all very familiar with this phenomenon. Also, it is about making sure that they don't have to use personal connections or bribe officials to get the information and service that they need and deserve. Let me give you one example. 200,000 sugarcane farmers now receive purchase orders for their canes through text messages on their cell phones. For decades, they used to receive this information on a piece of paper, which often would not reach them on time, would get lost on the way, or get torn in the rain. You know, canes lose weight as they start to dry. The small farmers would always get the paper notification, if at all, later than the larger, more connected farmers, thereby becoming totally marginalized. The digital purchase order system, known as e-purchi, is starting to change that dynamics for 200,000 farmers and has the potential to bring the same positive challenge for millions of other farmers in other sectors. Nearly 40% of the country's population now own mobile phones. If a family does not own a phone, it has access to one which is next door. If it doesn't have access to one next door, it has access to one two doors after it. One can access a phone in the nearest Union Parishad, which is the lowest tier of the local government in the country, very similar to the Indian panchayats. All 4,500 Union Parishads of the country were equipped with ICT centers as of November last year. The centers function as one-stop shops for various government departments, which are introducing e-services rapidly and progressively. A positive culture of competition has thus been created within the government, facilitated by the Prime Minister's office itself. Distinguished guests, the very important feature of Digital Bangladesh is its deliberate focus on citizens' needs and not on ICT per se. The hundreds of leadership development exercises that have taken place in the last 2 years around the country at different tiers have done some justice to internalize this feature in the minds of the decision makers. As a result, we are seeing a turning of the tide in the use of ICT in government. We are doing less of automation and more of service delivery. And in doing so, we are spending less money in delivering services, saving money for citizens to access these services. At the same time, we are making our citizens happier. I dare say they cannot be a better combination of doing more with less. Decentralization, globalization, widespread technology adoption by the bottom of the pyramid are only some of the factors that are now allowing citizens to produce services for each other and help the country at the same government at the same time. In the last 6 months, we have been seeing that phenomenon through the ICT centers in the Union Parishads around the country. Through a grassroots blog, common citizens and administration participating in the blog are solving local and national problems of allocation of resources collectively. Through a blog set up for secondary education, the teachers and teachers' trainers are sharing across the country multimedia educational content that they have developed. These examples are demonstrating the potential of co-creation. Firm Gartner included Bangladesh in the list of top 30 outsourcing destinations in 2010. An Islamic banking solution developed by a Bangladeshi software company was placed ninth globally in 2011. Bangladesh ranks among the top 20 countries for IT freelancing, and the country's capital, Dhaka, ranks third globally after two Indian cities. On the macroeconomic front, Moody's and Standard & Poor's have given very favorable credit rating to Bangladesh. Goldman Sachs has identified Bangladesh as one of the N11 or next 11 to become the world's largest economies after the BRIC countries. As we develop a strategy for positioning Bangladesh as an IT destination, it may be prudent to focus not only on software, but also perhaps even more strongly on IT-enabled services. We are faced with the reality of a youth bulge, with a third of the country's population falling in this category. Development of ICT-focused skills to employ a large number of young people in the IT-enabled service industry is a strategic decision for us. One or two success stories of the ICT-enabled skills development in our country. One was the very large work of voter registration in 2008. This was done electronically by over 50,000 secondary and higher secondary students who were trained for a week on ICTs. The elections conducted in December 2008 have been acclaimed universally, both internationally and domestically, as one of the freest and fairest and most transparent and credible elections. 87% of the voters, registered voters, turned out to vote. 50% plus were women. More critically important, 40 to 45% were youth voting for the first time. This is the youth bulge that I just referred to a little earlier. The second example is from the IT industry, where thousands of higher secondary graduates are employed to develop graphic design for American, European, and Japanese companies. I would like to conclude my statement with an announcement. The two themes of Digital Bangladesh that I just talked about, taking government services to citizens' doorsteps and making Bangladesh the next IT and ITES outsourcing destination, will be showcased to the world in this year's eAsia conference, which we just launched. We are very proud to announce that Bangladesh will host eAsia 2011 on December 1, 2, and 3. As you all know, eAsia is a premier ICT event of Asia with a view to foster greater cooperation between Asian countries in the area of technology-led development initiatives. The organizer of today's event, Center for Science, Development and Media Studies, or CSDMS, has partnered with the government and the private sector of Bangladesh to bring you eAsia 2011 in Dhaka. The conference will bring global experts on utilizing ICTs to improve healthcare, education, disaster management, government service delivery, and enabling outsourcing. India's own Narayan Murthy defines globalization as sourcing capital from where it is cheapest, sourcing talent from where it is best available, producing where it is most efficient, and selling where the markets are, without being constrained by national boundaries. This is a world which we all have to try and achieve or work towards. In this journey of excellence, I believe Asian nations must forge lasting bonds to develop the necessary human resources and create jobs with disposable income, which is the only sustainable way to fight poverty. I'm confident that eAsia 2011 will bring Asian countries and companies closer together to each other and to work towards the goal of Asia being at the forefront of technology-led development. I hope all of you will join us in December for eAsia 2011. In the meantime, I wish you a very productive eWorld Forum in the next 2 days. I thank you all.